Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to invert your artwork for a dark background. I'm going to show you three ways to do this, depending on what type of artwork you have. All right, let's get started. Okay, so if your artwork is like this, which is a thin, uninterrupted black outline that goes all the way around the artwork with no breaks, so it's completely connected all the way around, then jump to this timestamp. And by the way, I got all these images from vecteezy.com. And then if your outline does have breaks like this, jump to this timestamp to see what to do about those. And then finally, if part of your outline actually includes artwork like these spikes or his claws down here, jump to this timestamp. Okay, first we'll work on this turtle. Now, before doing anything else, you'll want to make sure that your artwork is simplified, divided, and united. And you can see how to do that in another video. It should be in the upper right-hand corner of your screen right now. He is all one color with no strokes. If you have strokes, you need to expand them. When I pull him off to the side, you can see he has no fill. I'm just going to copy and paste this. And if you don't have a background here, you'll need to add one. So just make a square around your image, making sure to include the entire image, make it white or any color really. And actually, I'm going to change this to yellow so you can see what's going on. I'll select both the background and the design, and then I'll come down here to Pathfinder and Divide. I'll hit A on my keyboard to get to my direct selection tool, and I'm going to click in this area outside the design and delete it. So now we have a filled area inside the turtle. I'm going to hit Shift-O to get to my artboard tool, and then I'm going to just click and drag, holding Shift and Option to make a copy. I'm going to draw a box around my entire yellow and black turtle and group it with Command-G or Control-G, and I'll delete this turtle. I'll change my background color to black, and then I'll put this turtle on the black. And now I can go ahead and change this to white. So I'll use my magic wand tool, the Y tool, and click any yellow part and then just change it to white. Now I want to show you what happens if we just change all the black parts up here to white and put it on a black background. So I'm going to hold Option and click and drag the background over here, and I'll make a copy of this turtle. I'm going to put it on black, and then I'll change all of the black to white. So here is the difference. Really the main problem here is the reversed out eyes. It looks really weird and is not a good look, but here they are not reversed. Now the problem with doing it this way is you do lose that outer outline. It just kind of fades into the black, but maybe you're okay with that. Now if you have breaks in your outline, you'll want to fill those in. So I'll use my pen tool and I'll just click here and fill in this area so that is solid. I want to do this with any breaks in that outline. And I'll just speed this up because it's probably a little boring. And then I'll go ahead and Pathfinder Unite. I can smooth out some of these areas so they look better. And then the process is the same. I'll hit Shift-O to get onto my artboard tool right over here. I'll click and drag and hold Shift and Option. I'm going to change my background. We'll just change that to black, and then I'll hide it with Command 3 or Control 3. And then I'm going to click on the very edge with my group selection tool, this tool right over here. And I'm going to copy that. I'll deselect. That is important. Deselecting is important in this case. I'll paste behind with Command B. And I'll change this to yellow also so you can see what's going on. Basically, I just copied that outer shape and pasted it behind the fish. Now I actually want this to be white, so I'll go ahead and change that to white. I'll add my dark background. We'll make that black, and I'll send to back, and I'm gonna make it the same color as my outline. I'll get into Command Y or Control Y mode to select my bubbles here, and I'm okay with these being completely white. So this ends up the same way as the first option, and you do lose some of the details of that outer outline. Now in this next option, I'll show you what to do if you wanna have those outlines be visible, or if a major part of your artwork will be missing if it ends up like this. Okay, and that is this version. I'm going to make a copy of this artboard by hitting Shift-O to get to my artboard tool, then clicking and dragging, holding Shift and Option or Shift and Alt on a PC. Now with this version, since we have these parts of the outline that are artwork, we're going to add another outline to this. With my group selection tool, I'm going to click on the very edge of the artwork so that I have just the outer path selected. I'll copy that. Deselect. Deselecting is very important. And then paste behind with Command B or Control B. I'm going to make my outline pink this time so you can see what's going on. I'll hit Shift X to switch the outline and the fill. And then I'm going to increase this. I'll make it 50 points and I'll go ahead and round the cap and the corner in my stroke panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing these panels over here, they're under window. For example, stroke is right here. Now I'm also going to have a pink fill for this. So I'm going to click and drag my stroke onto my fill. And this is what we get. And then I'll add my background box. We'll make this black. I don't need a stroke on that, so I'll get rid of that and send it back. So we could either leave this pink or we could turn it white. I'll use my group selection to click on a pink part, and now I can just make that white. Hit X to get my stroke or my fill in front and make that white too. So usually when you see like sports logos, they will always have a white outline around the edge if they're putting it on a dark background because the eyes will reverse and it makes it look really weird. So here's an example where they added a gray outline. Here's one with a white outline. And here's one where they've added a blue outline. So this looks much better and maintains the same look as the white background, as opposed to, you know, changing all the black to white and you get the reversed eyes and the weird look. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.